rise up in the morning beneath the stars so bright. Pull your hat down, make sure your cinch is tight. Horse is kinda snuffy, cold chill up your spine. Go get your ass moving, son, we're burning daylight.
Howdy there, I'm Matt McKinley and we're burning daylight. Welcome to Burnin' Daylight, the only podcast for the working cowboy.
Hello, Matt.
Howdy, Boots. How are you doing?
I'm still in the hospital, just sitting here, but I was standing up on my walker and had to sit down, but I'm just hanging in there, and that's about it. Just waiting on the doctors next week are supposed to rule, get with the physical therapist, the doctor, and the insurance, and rule whether they think I can make it at the bunkhouse or need to stay a few days. So I'll probably know something tomorrow or the next day.
Well,
how
good.
You doing out there?
Doing all right. It's I think it's supposed to warm up a little bit this week, so it won't be quite as cold. But yeah, we're doing all right. Getting ready for Thanksgiving.
Well, good. You about ready for a turkey?
Well, I imagine we'll have a turkey. I've never been much of a turkey fan. I ate a lot of beef growing up, so that's kind of what we cook is beef.
Yeah, we eat beef there at the ranch. They let the cook, she's telling me, buy chicken. We have fried chicken twice a month, but they told her that we're raising beef and buying chicken, so keep that in mind. So we have a lot more beef than we do fried chicken, and I'm glad of it, but it's a little fried chicken once in a while and gravy's pretty good.
Oh, it's never hurt anybody as far as I know.
No.
Yeah, well, a good fried chicken's pretty good, but we always raised beef, and we had a lot of pork too, but mostly beef.
Yeah, we've eat lots of pork in this country in the summer with wagons, because you could keep that pork and hams and shoulders up in the chuck box where you couldn't keep beef there in July and August.
Yeah.
So we've eat a lot of pork, but it's easy to carry. You can carry a lot of it. And used to have it, keep the bacon too in big sides, and it salted down. You could just pitch it in the back of the commissary and get it out and slice it up and have bacon. And so we had quite a bit of that, but we'd be wanting to kill the beef when we got a chance.
Oh yeah, I imagine that beef is hard to beat. I think it's about the best meat out there.
Yeah, I think so too. And I read a story recently where it is in a cattleman magazine of some kind, I can't think now, but they did a test, and some university kids kept up with it, and they had people that eat this and eat that, and they weighed and took a test every 3 months or something for a year, and they said at the end of the deal, the ones that ate straight beef all the way through had the highest IQ.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah.
Huh.
I don't know.
They haven't met very many cowboys, have they?
No. But I guess it smartens them up a little.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah.
Well, that's...
Are you all right out there today?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we're... Oh, my wife's kind of come down with a little bit of something or other. She's not feeling all that great, but the kids are kind of waiting on her hands and foot, so I don't think she minds too much.
Oh, yeah. Maybe they'll... Yeah, they tell me here at the hospital that there's been a lot of people over the country sick, especially young kids, that they accredited to them being isolated for a couple of years and not going to school, and they didn't become immune to all them little things that they just become immune to, and then how they all got them, and they said the hospitals of this one, that they tell me they're not got a bunch here, but they news showed that there's a lot of them. And we had a terrible loss here. It just happened, and they just called me 20 minutes ago that Dr. Blodgett died. He's been one of the mainstays here for 41 years.
That was your main veterinarian, right?
Yeah. He's
that's too bad.
In charge of the horse program also, you know, he was the main man on the stallions and mares and breeding and stuff.
Yeah.
Kind of developed the program. And so it is a pretty big shocker, but he had some surgery, and they thought he's doing fine, and had a relapse, and they jerked him back in there and tried to stabilize him and called back and told me in a little bit that he passed away. He was in Dallas in a big hospital, so it must have been pretty tough. But
well, that's too bad.
Be some changes in the ranch over that, because there's a lot of the stuff that he done I don't think anybody else there will do. The ranch will go on. That's not going to close it, but it'll change some things.
Oh, yeah. Now, he's the fellow that you introduced me to when we went over to the race barn, right?
Yeah, I thought so.
Yeah. Really nice guy. I was glad to meet him.
He was, he'd been president of the Quarter Horse Association, president of the deal at A&M, and received a lot of awards from A&M College in agriculture or animal stuff. He was a past master in that artificial insemination and stuff like that. But he's gone now. It was hurt all of a sudden. He just got sick, and they carried him in there for some surgery and thought he was going to be fine. And all of a sudden, he wasn't but 73 and relapsed him, and he died right quick. But he's family's in good shape. Had two grown daughters, and they're both grown, married, and got families, and then just him and his wife. She'll be all right.
Well, that's too bad, but I guess it happens.
Yeah, that's part of it.
Yeah.
I need to move again. I'm just sit down here on the edge of the bed. I'm on a walker, so I'm going to quit you and get up and move around. I was trying to get me a cord untangled that goes to the TV and pull it over in my easy chair, but I may have to call a nurse to get it because it's wrapped around a pole here.
Oh, okay.
That's not too big a problem, though.
But, well, good. Do they have the Cowboy channel there for you?
No, we don't have it.
Oh, dang.
I imagine they be a lot on there pretty quick about the ranch the finals, I guess.
Yeah, I imagine
that
so.
Starts next week, I guess, don't it?
I think so. I'm not for sure, but it coming up here quick. I know that.
Yeah, but I'll have it there at the ranch if I get to go back.
Yeah.
To the ranch, but right now it's going to be nip and tuck. I know I'd like to, but I know I'd be ahead, stay here a few more days.
Yeah.
See if I could get over this, but appreciate you calling, and I'll check with you in a day or two.
All right, sounds good. I'm going to call your daughter, and we're going to record a little bit for the show and tell some tall tales about you, okay?
All right, that'll be fine. Thank
you. All right, Boots, you take care, all right?
Come out good. Yeah, bye-bye.
All right, see you, Boots. Oh, what a guy. What a guy. I really enjoy old Boots O'Neill. He's one of a kind. So, anyway, I hope you guys enjoy these deals. I really do. So, who knows how much longer we're going to be able to do it. So, anyhow, you guys have a good week, and move your ass. We're burning daylight.
I'm kin to the roving wind that brings the northern in. Along that dusty trail I'll take my stand. The steers are big and bold, and the nights are often cold. But I'll get by as long as I can throw that rope and brand that calf. Dream of a girl in a photograph. I got no home, I got no wife, but I'll be a doggone cowboy all of my life. I'm up at the crack of dawn, and I throw the bacon on. Seems somehow my work is never through. When I get done at night, all the stars are big and bright. But then it's all of what you used to when you throw that rope, brand that calf, dream of a girl in a photograph. I got no home, I got no wife, but I'll be a doggone cowboy all of my life. The hot, dry wind may blow, and you'll see me in the rain and snow. With just an old campfire to keep me warm, I'll move the herd along, and I'll greet them with a song. So I guess that I was born to throw that rope, brand that calf, dream of a girl in a photograph. I got no home, I got no